look, one of my New Year's resolutions should be to learn to ride a bike properly.
Good. Everyone should know how to ride a bike.
I know, without stabilisers.
You're not feeling nauseous, are you? Arthur's back tomorrow afternoon at the same time. Experimental's up next today. Make sure you don't miss it.
Now, just starting over on the CBBC channel at its new time is Nelly Nutt Live. Now, don't miss this little lady. Her brand new series is on Thursday.
I'm Tracy Beaker, and I decide what I do, how I do it, and when I do it. Do you think I'm annoying? Well, you better get used to it. Because I'm not going anywhere.
The story of Tracy Beaker continues this Thursday at 4:20 on CBBC One.
See you Thursday, Tracy. Still to come this afternoon, we've got another brand new episode of The Rugrats for you.
Now, were you good at science at school?
Yeah.
You were? Well, you better watch this, it's experimental.
One rocket, two rockets. Which will go the furthest?
Experimental.
How many kids will it take to lift a ton of water?
Experimental.
And how much slack is there in our bungee cord?
Experimental.
Welcome to Experimental, the knockout competition to find the country's sharpest science sharks. There are two teams intellectually beating their brains out this week. In the red, from Nethergreen School in Sheffield, we have...
Jonathan.
Jack.
Inga.
And in green, from Oswald Road School in Manchester, we have...
Jack.
Erin.
Nathan.
Those are the teams! Be a rocket scientist to understand the rules. We'll show both teams the beginning of an experiment. Then, using smarts, sense, and science, they have to predict the experiment's outcome. Now, they will have the appropriate experimental equipment and the help, the knowledge of our science analysis matrix, Sam. Any thoughts, Sam?
Only two things are certain, the universe and human stupidity, Otis, and I'm not certain about the universe.
It's a good job I'm not human, then. Hey, wait a minute. Anyway, on with the first experiment. Outside this here research lab is our testing ground, and it's there that we join Chief Experimentor Holly Willoughby.
Welcome to the experimental testing ground. Now, this is rocket science. What we have here are three sets of rockets, a single rocket, two rockets strapped together, and two rockets strapped one behind the other. All the rockets are identical and contain equal amounts of gunpowder. Your challenge is to work out which pair of rockets will go the furthest and exactly how far will they go. Now, to give you a clue, Herbie's going to set the single rocket off now. Rocket went 11.1 metres. So that's back to you.
OK, guys, that is your challenge and your experimental time starts now. For safety reasons, the team cannot fire rockets in the lab, but they can get similar results by releasing balloons along strings. Okay. Jonathan, how far did the first balloon go?
2 meters, 31 centimeters.
Lovely. Okay, I'm about to release the twin set of balloons now. Here we go. Wow. Okay, Nathan, how far did that go?
3 meters, 26 centimeters.
Releasing the tandem balloons. And the booster rocket. In 3, 2, 1. Okay, Inga, how far did that go?
3 meters, 30 centimeters.
Okay. Sam, what is it they need to do here? Because, I mean, a balloon is not a rocket, right?
One rocket carries its own weight. Two rockets together, twice the power, but twice the weight. Tandem rockets, they lose weight as the first rocket falls away.
Okay, teams, your time is up. Team captains, your predictions, please.
The tandem rocket, 15.857 metres.
Tandem rocket, 15.87 metres.
Okay, then, let's see how their answers tie into reality. Holly.
Right, Otis, the area is now secured, and for safety reasons, the rockets will be fired electrically. And in charge of ignition is our resident technician, Herbie. Oh, Herbie, not now. It's time to start the countdown on the rockets that are strapped together. So, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right, Herbie, fire the next pair of rockets.